Hey guys, Joey here again today. Today I'm going to show you how to make a very simple, very easy, very cheap, and extremely effective aquarium filter. Now with the recent peak in interest in the K1 Caldness media, this is going to be a fluidized bed filter. Now K1 has been around for about 10 years now, but mainly used in ponds. Over the last couple of years, it's starting to increase in popularity in the aquarium world. So I'm going to show you how to make a very simple filter. Here's the supplies you're going to need. You're going to need some airline tubing. You're going to need a sponge. This is just an ugly sponge I had around. Preferably I like to use like an aqua clear sponge, something with a lot larger pore structure than this simple sponge here. But anyways, it's just what I had on hand and it works. So that's what do-it-yourself is actually all about, using whatever you have on hand to create something. You'll also need an air pump, a bottle, preferably 2 liter or 1 liter depending on the size of your aquarium. And you're also going to need a couple of suction cups. Now the suction cups I'm using, I believe, came from a heater. If you can see, they have a nub here. A nub right here that is going to be needed. So something similar to that is what you're going to need. So to start out, you take your pop bottle or juice bottle, rinse it very well, remove the cap, and drill some holes in it. I'll tell you why we're drilling holes in that later. Next is a hole in the neck of the bottle here. Now the hole only needs to be slightly smaller than your airline tubing. The reason being is because you're not siliconing it in place. You want it to just simply be held snugly in there. Now if you use a drill bit that is slightly smaller than your airline tubing, you'll accomplish just that. Next is a couple of holes in the side of the bottle. Preferably near the bottom and near the top. After that, some holes at the top of the bottle. Actually this would be the bottom, but we're going to be positioning this upside down, so this is now the top. The more holes you create, the more bubbles you're going to get out of the top and the quieter it will be. You'll see that later in the video when we show this actually functioning. So for putting this together, it's really quite simple. You take your K1 Caldness media, which I have here. This is about a liter of it, as you can see. If you look at my other videos, you'll be able to get some more information on this K1 Caldness. Take your K1 Caldness and fill up your bottle. I like to use a large mouth bottle because it's simply easier to get your Caldness in, and it comes with a bigger cap which allows you to have many holes in it. So once you fill up your bottle with the K1 Caldness, you can go ahead and insert your airline hose. So it's going to be a tight fit to get it in there, but it will go in. Now, you just want the exit of the hose to be in about the midway point, and it should just stay in there by itself. As you can see, it's not going to go anywhere. From there, put your cap back on. Again, we've already got the Caldness in there. And then you can put your suction cups on. Now, this is the reason for the nubs on the suction cups. Is because they can squeeze in, but they can't come out. They will come out if you pull on them, but they're in there firm enough to hold themselves in place. So that's it. Next, take your sponge. I've already cut a hole in it, and put it over this, over the end here. And that's it. Plug it into your airline tube, put it in your tank, and turn your air pump on. And that's it. Now the reason why we drilled the holes in here in the cap is very simple. I wanted the maintenance to be extremely low on a filter like this. And the reason being is for these holes is when you're ready to clean your sponge, which should be weekly, the more often the better, because it's only used for mechanical. There's really no biological purpose that you should be using it for. That's what your K1's for. While you will have some nitrifying bacteria on the sponge, you should want most of your bacteria here, so clean your sponge often. So when you remove your sponge, you can leave your filter running. If you didn't have a cap and your filter was still running, you're going to have a lot of K1 coming out. The only way to avoid that is to turn the air line off, the K1 will float to the top, and then you could take the sponge off. This is just a lot easier. So that's basically it. I'm going to show you installation, what it will look like in your tank, and turning it on. That's it. The cost of something like this is, I had this sponge kicking around, so that's free. Airline hose, I don't know, maybe 10 cents a foot, or 25 cents a foot, depends on where you're shopping, so you're not looking at a lot of money there, maybe $1 or $2. Pop bottles free, unless you're going to buy it, of course, but you get to drink the pop or juice out of it, so you're going to do that anyways. So this is pretty much free. Suction cups, probably have some kicking around. If you don't, they're pretty cheap as well, maybe 30, 40 cents. K1 Caldness Media is what's going to cost you the most. There's not a lot of places that sell it by the liter, but I've noticed on eBay there is one place, I believe it's in the UK though, and I think he wants around $10 to $15 a liter, which is pretty expensive, but if you can find something local, or maybe find a few friends that want to split on a 25 liter bag, it should only cost you maybe $3 per liter, $2 to $3 a liter. Then your air pump, maybe 10, 15 bucks. So no more than $20 for everything. Now you could make several of these and run several tanks. Something like a 2 liter size with 1 liter of K1 should be able to handle a nicely stocked 30 gallon tank, 25 to 30 gallon tank. If you ran maybe two of them, you're looking at maybe a 50 gallon tank, 55 gallon tank. Then you can upgrade maybe to a 4 liter jug and have that in the tank. Now I know that it would be an eyesore and you don't really want to see it, but once you see it in action, it actually looks pretty cool. If somebody come to your house, it's a great conversation piece. You're guaranteed they're going to ask, what's that? But anyways, so we have a very effective, very cheap, very easy, and aquarium filter, so give it a shot. If you do end up trying this and you take some pictures of it, join my Facebook page and put some pictures on there. I'd love to see what everybody else is coming up with. But anyways, let's have a look at this in action. So the filter is installed in the tank now. As you can see, it just sucks the cups to the side. This is a prime example as to why you'd want to position the airline when putting it into your bottle, to have it in the back of the bottle. That way you can hide the airline behind it. Also, you can notice that the K1 floats up first. It will float no matter if the media is cycled or not. For maintenance, all you gotta do is remove this sponge, rinse it off, and put it back on. That's it. That's the reason why we had the cap staying on, is so that you can do that without shutting the filter off. You can remove the sponge and the media will not get out, so you can leave it running. Very easy. You never have to clean the K1 itself, ever. So I'm going to go ahead and turn the filter on here. Now the reason why you don't want to use an air stone is because the air bubbles coming out of your pump are going to agitate the K1 media a lot a lot better than an airstone would. The airstone puts out several tiny bubbles, and this is going to put out larger bubbles, which will cause a lot more suction and move the K1 around a little bit more. Now, the way this works is water is, well, as the air bubbles rise, it's causing suction behind it. So it's causing water to be sucked up through this sponge. So all water from the tank is sucked up through this sponge and filtered through the K1 exiting at the top. Placement of the bottle itself depends on where you want to have it. I prefer to have it about an inch below the water surface so you can get some surface agitation. If the noise is too much, drill some extra holes in there so there's more bubbles coming out and it won't be so noisy. So that's basically it. I mean, you'll be able to see that I can add more media to this filter here. There's plenty of room in there, and you can play it by ear and see if you can fit more in yours. That's basically it. Very simple filter. Probably the easiest filter you'll ever have to maintain. It covers your mechanical filtration and your biological. You don't really need chemical filtration unless you're trying to remove medication from an aquarium, like using activated carbon, for example. So this is it. Very simple, very cheap, very easy, and extremely effective.